This is Chapter 9, Section 1, Problem 35. The maximum weights in kilograms for which one repetition of a half squat can be performed, and the jump heights for 12 international soccer players are given. The accompanying table, correlation coefficient, rounded to 3 decimal places, is given to us here at no significance is at 0.05. Is there enough evidence to conclude that there's a correlation here? Okay, since we're testing whether or not a correlation exists, if there's no correlation, then R is zero. Okay, so that's how we set up here. No correlation, R is zero. Not equal to zero, that means that there's a correlation, not equal to zero. So in this case here, we have what? N is 12. So for this problem here, the degrees of freedom will be N minus 2. So we can find our boundaries here. So I can go to Stat, Calculators, and T. We already said that degrees of freedom will be N minus 2. So it'll be 12 minus 2, which is 10. Okay. And the significance is going to be half of that. So half of 0.05 is going to be what? 0.0025. That should give me 0.5 there. And if you go to the left, that should give us a negative value. And that gives me the area to the negative there. Okay. And if we touch the arrow, we can get it to go to the right. So what this represents is our rejection region here. So if our test statistic lands within here, we reject the null hypothesis. If it lands in here, we reject the null hypothesis. If it doesn't land in here, then we fail to reject the null hypothesis. Okay. So that's what our critical values look like. So if our test statistic lands in this region here, in this interval, then we fail to reject the null hypothesis. So we have to find the test statistic. We can use that regression here to find that. Go to Stats, go to Regression, Simple Linear, select X and the Y. So you can hit Compute. And we're interested in the t-stat that goes with the slope. And there it is there. Right here. That's our test statistic there. And there it is entered there. Okay, notice this test statistic falls in this interval here. So since it falls within that interval, we end up, where is that right here? Come out and look at it. 3.3 is on the outside of it, because intervals be within that two there. That's going to be on the outside of it. So we end up rejecting the null hypothesis. Say that again. So you see this interval here. If it falls within this interval, we end up rejecting the null hypothesis. If it falls outside of it, we end up rejecting it here. So that's rejecting it. It's outside the interval. So we reject it.